Ghiyasuddin Balban, who ruled India as the Sultan of Delhi, was the greatest sultan of the slave dynasty, and an extremely shrewd military chief. Balban was a great warrior, ruler, and statesman, who saved the infant Muslim state from extinction at a critical time. Balban will ever remain a great figure in medieval Indian history. His period has been marked as an illustrious chapter in the history of Delhi Sultanate. In spite of having only a few military achievements, Balban reformed civil and military lines that earned him a stable and prosperous government. Balban was the son of a Central Asian Turkic noble. As a child, he and others from his tribe were captured by the Mongols and sold as slaves in Ghazni. He was sold to Khwaja Jamaluddin of Basra. Khwaja took him to Delhi, where he was purchased by Sultan Shamshuddin-il-Tutmish. During his stay at Delhi, Il-Tutmish was very much impressed by the intelligence and ability of Balban, and enrolled him as a member of the famous corps of the 40 slaves. During the reign of Razia Sultan, he was the Lord of the Hunt, a position of some importance at the time, having military and political responsibilities. He was loyal to Razia in his early days. But, later on he joined hands with the nobles, who deposed Razia Sultana from the throne of Delhi successfully. Balban was instrumental in the overthrow of Alauddin Majid, installing Nasir Mahmud as sultan, and himself as wazir. He also strengthened his relations with Sultan, by his daughter in marriage to him. The Sultan, being pleased with the loyalty and devotion of Balban, bestowed on him with the title of Ulugh Khan, and made him deputy sultan. His power and popularity grew more and more. He put down a number of internal rebellions, and also checked the external aggressions, especially of Mongols. Mongol army repletion could be achieved because his cavalry horses were better suited to Indian climate, and naturally bred larger than Mongols' army. He unsuccessfully laid siege to the fortress of Ranthambore, but did recapture Gwalior from the Rajputs. Sultan Nasiruddin did not have a male heir, so after his death, Balban ascended the throne by assuming the title of Ghiyasuddin Balban. Balban's experience as the regent made him understand the problems of Delhi Sultanate. He knew that the real threat to the monarchy was from the nobles called the 40. He was convinced that only by enhancing the power and authority of the monarchy, he could solve his problem. He got every member of Iltutmish's family killed, and gave a deadly blow to Chahalgani, or 40. Balban at first made out his concept of theory of kingship to his subjects. Secondly, he emphasized on external dignity and prestige as essential for kingship. He organized his court on the Iranian model, and followed the rules and ceremonials of the Persians very strictly. Balban introduced rigorous court discipline, and new customs, such as sihada, prostration, and kiss the sultan's feet, to prove his superiority over the nobles. In order to impress the people, Balban maintained a magnificent court, and also introduced the Persian festival of Nowruz. When Balban became the sultan, his position was not secure. Many Turkish chiefs were hostile to him. The Mongols were looking forward for an opportunity to attack the Sultanate. The governors of the distant provinces were trying to become independent rulers, while Indian rulers were also ready to revolt. Some of the Rajput Zamindars had set up forts in the area. The Muwaddis had become so bold as to plunder people up to the outskirts of Delhi. Balban reorganized his army and made it strong and efficient, as it was the main pillar of his despotic government. However, Balban did not introduce any revolutionary change in the military organization. But certainly he raised the efficiency and morale of the army. Bengal was a part of the Delhi Sultanate, and its governor Tughril Khan was a slave of Balban. In 1279, he declared the independence of Bengal and assumed the title of Sultan. Balban sent his forces to Bengal, and had Tughril Khan beheaded. Subsequently, he appointed his own son Bughra Khan as the governor of Bengal. The Mongol invasion was frequent on the border, and it was a constant headache to Sultan Balban. He built a line of forts along the frontier, and garrisoned them with able-bodied Afghan soldiers, and appointed Shere Khan, as the commander of the army at the border. Shere Khan was successful against the Mongols, on a number of occasions. But unfortunate death of Shere Khan, the Mongols started their plundering raids without any fear. Balban sent his son, Prince Mahmud, against them. But the prince was killed in the battle, and his death was a smashing blow to Balban. Though he reoccupied Lahore from the Mongols, but he could not recover himself from the shocks of his son's death. Prince Muhammad was his most favorite son. Balban then nominated Kai Khusrav, the son of his eldest son Prince Muhammad, as his heir. He died in 1287 at the age of 80.